Hello world, it's Rahul. Welcome back guys to machine learning tutorial. So guys, we have discussed basic intuition of entropy, information gain, Gini impurity, and how can we solve classification problem by making use of these factors. If you haven't watched that video yet, then please go and watch so that you will have clear understanding before jumping to today's topic. I have attached the video link into the description. So guys, today I am going to discuss that how can we solve regression problem through decision tree. Let's quickly understand this by using real world example. So guys, we are going to use this dataset as shown on the screen. Here, column outlook, temp, humidity and windy are input and hours played is output or target column. So according to weather conditions, model has to predict how many hours user can play the game outside. Here, we'll be going to use ID3 algorithm for constructing decision tree for regression by replacing information gain with standard deviation reduction. So guys, let's understand how we are going to use standard deviation over here. A decision tree is built top down from a root node and involves partitioning the data into subsets that contain instances with similar values. We use standard deviation to calculate the homogeneity of a numerical sample. If a numerical sample is completely homogeneous, its standard deviation will be zero. Let's calculate the standard deviation for our target value. So, here we have 14 observations, so our count will be denoted as n is equal to 14. Now, we will calculate mean, and that will be sum of all observations divided by total number of observations, and that is 39.8. So here we have a formula for standard deviation, and that is square of observation minus mean over total number of observation, and this we will calculate for each and every observation. So we can rewrite it as summation of square of x minus x mean over n. Now we will substitute the value of n as 14 and x min as 39.8. So our standard deviation will be calculated as 9.32. We will calculate coefficient of variation as well. And that will be equal to standard deviation over mean of observation x into 100%. Guys, one thing to note here is we are using standard deviation for building tree branches, and coefficient of variation makes sure when we have to stop branching the tree. Now let's work with two attributes, one from input column and another one is target variable. So let's calculate standard deviation for column outlook as shown on the screen. So we have three observations for outlook, that is overcast with count of 4. And when I say a count of 4, that means overcast is present 4 times in column outlook, as you can see on the screen. Okay, so rainy with count of 5 and sunny is also with count of 5. So guys, I have already calculated standard deviation for these observations. Now let's multiply each of the standard deviation with its probability of occurrence so that we will get standard deviation for complete outlook column with respect to target column. This will be equated as S of hours play and outlook is equal to probability of sunny into standard deviation of sunny plus probability of overcast into standard deviation of overcast plus probability of rainy into standard deviation of rainy. So here probability will be number of count over total number of observations. So guys, now we have standard deviation for column outlook with respect to target variable as 7.66. We will find out the standard deviation for rest of the three columns, that is temp, humidity and windy, by following the same steps what we have used for outlook column. So guys, as we have calculated standard deviation for all four columns with respect to target variable, now the dataset will split on the different attributes, and for that we have to subtract the resulting standard deviation from the standard deviation before the split. And this whole process is known as standard deviation reduction. So let's understand what is this standard deviation reduction means. The standard deviation reduction is based on the decrease in standard deviation after a data split is split on an attribute. Constructing a decision tree is all about finding attribute that returns the highest standard deviation reduction, that is the most homogeneous branches. So after subtracting the resulting standard deviation from actual standard deviation, we have this table as shown on the screen. So here, the attribute with the largest standard deviation reduction is chosen for the decision node. And as you can see, Outlook has the highest standard deviation reduction. Now, the dataset is divided based on the values of the selected attribute, that is Outlook column. This process will run recursively on non-leaf branches until all the data is processed. But we must have some termination criteria. So let's say I set a threshold value for coefficient of variation as 10%, and when coefficient of variation for a branch becomes smaller than a certain threshold, then subset will not need any further splitting. So let's calculate coefficient of variation for values of Outlook column. So formula for this will be standard deviation over x mean into 100%. So guys, as you can see on the screen, Overcast has coefficient of variation as 8%, which is less than threshold value. So we will not split this subset further, and the related leaf node gets the average of Overcast subset, that is 46.3. Now we have to split the node Sunny and Rainy. So here Sunny has 28% of coefficient of variation. Let's further split this. So we will repeat the same process what we did earlier for table as shown on the screen. So guys, one thing to note here is that I'm not taking any new data set. I'm just extracting the row which is having value as Sunny in Outlook column. And same I will do for value Rainy, but later on. Okay, so again, we will calculate standard deviation for values of each column as shown on the screen. Then we have to find out the standard deviation reduction, and we will select the column which is having the highest standard deviation reduction value. So here Windy has the maximum standard deviation reduction. So guys, here we have two values for Windy column, that is true and false. We stop further branching and assign the average of each branch to the related leaf node, as the number of data points for both branches false and true is equal or less than 3. And if we calculate coefficient of variation for these branches, we will always get values less than threshold. Let's find out the subset split for node Rainy. For node Rainy, we have data set as shown on the screen. We will calculate standard deviation for the values of each column as shown on the screen. Then we have to find out the standard deviation reduction, and temp has the high standard deviation reduction. So now we can go to node temp for further splitting, but again the number of data points for all three branches, that is mild, hot and cool, is equal to or less than 3. So we will stop further branching and assign the average of each branch to the related leaf node. So guys, now we have complete decision tree for regression analysis. But one thing to note here is, when the number of instances is more than 1 at leaf node, then we calculate the average as the final value for target variable. Thank you guys for your time. Do like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon to get the latest updates. Happy learning and stay safe.